There are supposedly only 6 silver known in the world. Do you know how many of the copper exist?
It's less than 10.
Less than 10?
The census is less than 10.
10. And as far as the pewter is concerned, is it about the same? Or?
It's about the same. In all metals, it's an extremely rare metal.
And so even though there were 300 of these, of course, they were scattered around the world.
They're scattered throughout. Yeah, they were found as far away as Hawaii.
The Columbian Washington medal has been the touchstone for this series. It is the rarest of all American medals. Only about 20 are known to exist today.
We'll be in Philadelphia in conjunction with the Whitman Coin and Collectibles Expo. I am in numismatic sales, so while I'm in the office, I help find coins for clients and help build collections. I also help bring the consignments in once they're complete to bring to auction, and I am the auctioneer. It's going to be a jam-packed 3-day event for sure.
It was supposed to be an 8-episode series, but we realized we needed to have an introduction to this, and that's why we focused on the Columbian Washington medal. Just last week, we realized one of the Columbian Washington medals is actually going up for auction in Philadelphia, so we're headed there today. I came to Philadelphia. I wanted to talk about this guy, but I want to meet this guy first.
Hey,
Tom, good to meet you.
How's it
finally.
Going, Andy?
Yeah, we had to come all the way down to Philadelphia to find a Bruins fan. but the great thing is we just were walking along here and we see Robert Morris. Now, the cool thing about Robert Morris is when John Ledyard came back from going AWOL with the British Marines, he came back to Connecticut. He was trying to find somebody to finance the first American expedition around the world to trade furs on the Northwest coast to China and then bring it back to the United States. And he went to the richest man in the country at the time, and that's Robert Morris. And he spent months trying to put together an expedition, looking at ships, going up to Boston, going to New London, looking at a ship called the Columbia. And then finally, Robert Morris decided that he really didn't need to take the risk to go to the Northwest coast, and they were going to go directly to China. And when Ledyard found out about that, there really wasn't any reason for him to be around anymore. So he went off, and the Empress of China left from New York and was the first American ship to China to come back again and brought back all the riches. And we just found Morris. History that you stumble upon. That's awesome. That is the one guy we hadn't picked yet.
Robert Morris was the richest man in the United States. He actually financed the American Revolution. So if Morris had kept on with Ledyard, the first American voyage around the world would have left New York in 1785, and there would be no Columbia and Washington medal. Instead, the expedition left Boston on September 30th, 1787.
Just a few weeks after they drafted the Constitution here and sent it out to the states to be ratified, Columbia left Boston 223 years ago today.
Well, that's a coincidence, but the 223rd anniversary probably wouldn't be observed of anything by me. This is my medal, and I have acquired a silver medal, uncirculated, so I don't have to have two of them.
What draws you to this particular piece?
It's just very, very intriguing. A numismatic item, in my opinion. It has a great story. I once wrote a chapter in a book all about it called More Adventures with Rare Coins.
What would you say the value would be on something that is so very rare like this?
Well, I believe it brought $4,000 the last time it was auctioned. It might open up and the auctioneer might say, we have $8,000, do I hear $8,500? Do I hear $8,500? Do I hear $8,500? Going once, going twice. This is a very, very real possibility for $8,000 sold to the internet, you know, and so you won't see things. It's not like a cattle auction where someone says, how can you let this go for $8,000? So we'll just see what it sells for. My guess is it'll probably sell for somewhere between $8,000 and $15,000, but I don't know.
It defies my belief that this is just sitting in a tray. Oh my God.
Thank you again for giving us your time and for being here tonight, and we hope you are a very successful buyer.
I've got two.
I've 8.5 on the floor, 9 on the web, 9.5, 1,000.
14 more to go.
1,100. So 4,000 to the book. Lot 4,196. 14,000, 15,000, looking for 16,000. 16,000 here, 17. I have 16,000 at the table, looking for 17,000. Last call. So 16,000 to the table. And the next lot, 4,197.
$16,000. And it started off at $5,000 last week. But online, it had already doubled practically to well over $9,000. The bidding started, boom, at $14,000 and went to $16,000. So that's been pretty exciting. But this is the end of our trip.
So we came to Philadelphia to cover this auction of the Columbia Washington Medal, and here we were brought back to Robert Morse. We had no idea we were going to find his statue here, just bumped right into it. And that's how it works. You start following a story and you find threads scattered all over the place. Robert Morse, who was connected to John Ledyard and the first American voyage to China, but not the first American voyage around the world, which is our story. As we wrap up this series of biographies, these are all the people who were involved in the story from the start, but there are more people who came into the story later on, and we're going to follow theirs around the world.